everyone, and welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to be talking about my master's in mechanical engineering in France. So my background is I'm Malaysian and I moved to France at 18 to pursue engineering, and I recently graduated in December 2023 with a master's in mechanical engineering with a major in industrial design. And a lot of you have been asking me to talk about my master's, what does it consist of, what were the courses like, so I thought of making this video to talk about just that. Now before we get into the video, it would mean so much to me if you guys could click on that subscribe button I upload every Sunday. So the system in France is such that to become a board certified engineer, you have to do what is called a diplôme d'ingénieur, and it's a 5-year course. And I think the system is similar to other countries in Europe as well, because I know, for example, like in Spain and in Italy, you also have to do an engineering program for 5 years. Now at the end of the 5 years, you graduate with a diplôme d'ingénieur, which is the equivalent of a master's in science in engineering in the US. Because it's a different system, it's kind of hard to give you guys like a direct equivalent to what it is. All you have to know is that it's a 5-year program, and at the end of the 5 years, you get a diplôme d'ingénieur. So I'm going to be talking about the program in 3 different parts based on my education pathway. So the first one is 2 years of technical degree, followed by 2 years of general mechanical engineering, and 1 year of my major, and also 1 year of worth of internship. So let's start with the first 2 years in my technical degree. So just before we get into it, I want to explain that you need to go to an engineering school and école d'ingénieur to get the diplôme d'ingénieur, but before going into like the 3rd, 4th, and 5th year, you can get into the engineering school with different paths. So you can either do like a licence, or you can do a classe préparatoire, or you can do a DUT, which is what I did. So I did my DUT in mechanical and production engineering in Le Havre in the north of France, and my 2 years were broken down into 4 semesters. Now at the end of the 2 years, you get an actual degree, and what a DUT does essentially is it forms you to be a technician, but a lot of people also use that to go into engineering schools later on. So unlike the preparatory classes, the DUT has a different approach. It's like 50% theoretical and 50% project based. And honestly, I think that I learned the most during the 2 years in an EUT. It really helped me get a solid base, and especially because I was going to do mechanical engineering, for me it was extremely important that I get like that practical exposure, that I get my hands dirty, like I know how to operate a machine, I know how to make pieces, and that's essentially what I did. And because of its 50-50 approach, it really helps you apply what you learn theoretically in the classes in projects and in, practical sessions. Also in my DUT, the girl-to-boy ratio was like bonkers, because I remember that there were only 3 girls, including myself, in a class of 54 people. So you can say that I definitely learned a lot, and I developed a lot of skills as well being in a very male-dominated area. And if you want me to make a video on what it's like being a female mechanical engineer, then let me know in the comment section down below. So during the 4 semesters in this DUT program, I had to study very hard because I knew that I wanted to integrate an engineering school later on. And when you're coming from a DUT background, you need to have really good grades and also a really good ranking in your class. So during that 2 years, that was my only focus, to get the best ranking that I was capable of getting in order to integrate a good engineering school. So with a lot of hard work, I did manage to do that, and I entered Université de Technologie de Compiègne, and I also made another video talking about why I chose this engineering school, so feel free to check it out. But the main reasons why I chose it is because the system was very much different compared to the French engineering system, meaning that it was more American based in the sense that you get to pick your own classes, you get to pick your own courses, the timetable was a lot more flexible, and you also did not have classes from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. every single day, and that, my friends, was the best thing. So now let's move on to the second part, which is the 2 years of general mechanical engineering. When I entered UTC during my first year, it was COVID, it was the year 2020, so it was really tough. And during this first year, I basically did a lot of courses based on general mechanical engineering, and I also started like a few subjects to initiate my master's. So during my first year, I took subjects like mathematics, material sciences, resistance of materials, languages, Spanish, English, economics, graphic design, communication design, and a little introduction to programming. Now, I would say the first semester in particular was the hardest, because I had to get used to the rhythm coming from an EUT. The rhythm in an engineering school is like so much more intense, and the classes were also so much more theoretical, and I was really afraid of failing, so I guess like with all that stress, it made the first semester the hardest. Also, classes were divided into lectures, tutorials, and practical sessions, and I had about 24 hours of classes per week. And obviously, besides that 24 hours, I had to put in a lot of time on my own studying autonomously. We had mid and final year exams, which is not the case in most of the engineering schools because they function on a more like continuous examination method, and like I cannot for the death of me, it just does not work for me. I rather study hard and intensely for like a certain period during the semester to pass like major exams instead of like studying every single day consistently to do like continuous exams. There were also certain subjects where we had projects or research-based projects that counted for like 30% of the grade. It depends on each subject actually. So I managed to pass every single subject in my first year. Thank God, it was a huge relief, and it also took off like a huge imposter syndrome because I was like, I deserve my place in this school. Now in my second year, I started it off with a 6-month internship at L'Oréal, and that's when I discovered my passion for product development. I basically worked as a color and artwork product developer for the brand La Roche-Posay. I also made an entire series about my life in L'Oréal and how I got my internships there, so don't hesitate to check that out as well. And then after that internship, I came back for a 4th semester at university, and that was by far the most intense semester, but also the most fun one. Now during the 4th semester, I focused a lot more on the science subjects and also worked towards completing my major. So I had subjects like fluid mechanics, I had a project related to my major by the side. I had product design, ergonomics, and I also took Italian for a bit. Now, I say that this semester was the hardest one and the most intense one because I had a lot of classes, and the classes were hard. Like, I had heavy scientific subjects that were known to not be easy. And at the same time, I was also involved with projects and extracurricular activities on the side. Also, because I integrated engineering school when it was COVID, this was the time where everything was open and everything was back to normal, so I got to experience like the full student life of being a student at UTC. And then moving on to my final year at engineering school, I kicked off the semester with my final academic semester ever, and to be honest, that semester was really light because I had passed all of my subjects previously. I already had extra credits, and so I did not have to take 6 subjects like in a classic semester. I just took 4 because I wanted to take the bare minimum and focus on internship hunting. So the subjects I took were quality management, project management, international management, and value analysis. So they were more focused on like management and industrial knowledge. Now, even though it was a light semester overall, I still found it really hard because I put so much of pressure on myself to find my final year internship. And the reason why I pressured myself so much was because I was so determined to land a good internship, and also because it's usually your final year internship which lands you your first job. So it is important. I was really hard on myself, and honestly, I think mentally I was not doing okay. Also because like my friends were abroad doing their exchange semesters, doing their gap semesters, so it was a pretty tough semester. And then I finally managed to land my final year internship with L'Oréal, but this time with the luxury division. So I interned as a product development engineer for the brand Lancôme, and I got to work on developing some makeup products that you will see this year. So during the 6 months, my final semester and my final year internship, it really confirmed my passion and my love for the job. I loved what I was doing. I loved developing products, and I also loved being in that company and being in that industry. And I was also so happy to be back in Paris at that time because honestly, Paris is just my happy, safe place. And so I ended my internship with my final presentation and my end of year report, and I passed with an A. So it all ended on a good note. So that marks the end of this video. I hope that I was able to give you guys an insight to what it's like studying engineering in France. Overall, it was difficult, it was tough, but I did have my highs and lows, and I think just generally I learned a lot, and I am happy that I did it. If you guys have any questions, do let me know in the comment section down below, and I'll see you in my next video. Ciao!